broadcasting from the Public Relations Department.
Hi, Hi Diary. Your editorial column. This is the background that brings you Thailand in perspective.
Udon in Thailand.
This is Udon in Thailand. Thailand's commercial authorities have joined hands with China's e-commerce giant Alibaba to help small businesses in Thailand reach more customers. The e-commerce platform is providing a new service package for Thai sellers, which should allow them to reach more customers and communicate with them more effectively. The Department of International Trade Promotion has joined hands with China-based global e-commerce provider Alibaba on the promotion of small and medium-sized businesses on the platform. The company has introduced a new package common for suppliers like in Thailand that helps sellers reach global customers easily. The Director General of the Office of Digital Commerce Market states Thailand's e-commerce market value is expected to exceed 7 trillion baht within this year with a 23% growth rate. And the Alibaba side, the head of Thailand business at Alibaba, say the newly introduced package leverages artificial intelligence to improve the platform's performance, collect data, and analyze customers and market trends, allowing businesses to improve their products and adjust their marketing strategy. The package also offers an automated chat and an easy-to-use interface for beginners. The package features a supplier rating system, social programs, and rewards to connect to capable buyers and multilingual support across 16 languages, including automated translation. Alibaba.com currently has more than 48 million buyers across 190 countries on its platform, with customers from the United States, Pakistan, and the Middle Eastern countries showing the most interest in Thai products. Popular Thai products are food and beverage, agricultural products, beauty products, clothes and fashion accessories, and home and office. Living at ASEAN, Foreign Affairs Minister advocated for enhanced ASEAN integration at the 57th ASEAN Ministerial Meeting in Vientiane, Laos, emphasizing the need for a unified digital economy system, stronger sustainable development, and voice-based regional security. Highlighting ASEAN's diversity as a foundation, highlighting ASEAN's diversity as a foundational point, the profound strategic initiative for deepened regional cooperation. The Thai minister also expressed support for the establishment of an ASEAN outlook on the Indo-Pacific Forum alignment in Nations Sustainable Development Goals for 2030, striving for collective regional achievement. Regarding security, Thai side emphasized utilize the Treaty of Amity and Cooperation in Southeast Asia to ensure regional peace and stability. He urged other countries to strengthen efforts against transnational crimes to establish mechanisms like the ASEAN Narcotics Cooperation Center and the ASEAN Working Group on anti-organized scams. Then finally, Thailand to begin FTA negotiations with EAEU. Minister of Commerce has confirmed that the government is expected to begin negotiations for a free trade agreement for FTA with the Eurasian Economic Union, or EAEU. The development follows discussions with Kazakhstan, the ambassador to Thailand, Oman, focusing in boosting bilateral trade, investment, and tourism. The talks also led to an agreement to establish a joint commission on trade and economic cooperation between Thailand and Kazakhstan. The EAEU are consisting of Russia, Armenia, Belarus, Kazakhstan, and Tajikistan, represents a major economic bloc of nearly 200 million people and a combined GDP of $5 billion. In addition to the FTA discussions, Thailand is exploring opportunities to export agricultural products and animal feed to Kazakhstan, taking advantage of the growing demand in Thailand's competitive pricing in trade sector. The reason visa extension agreement between the two countries is expected to enhance economic and investment ties further. In 2023, bilateral trade between Thailand and Kazakhstan totaled $172 million, with Thailand exporting $76 million worth of goods, including car and rubber products, is exporting $96 million, primarily in feed, petroleum, and mineral products. And before, what's that in Thailand? Coming up next, Thai Thai Diary in the part of China only.
Thank you.
Southern provinces away from conflict and its unity.
and Nearest offers supporting not only the peace dialogue, but also overall improvement of the three southernmost provinces. Malaysia's support was reiterated ahead of 2024 when the leaders of Thailand and Malaysia met to affirm ties and cooperation on mutually beneficial projects. Underlined during talks between the premiers of each nation were that promoting peace in Thailand South was necessary and would also add to efforts by the two countries to address security challenges along their borders. It was agreed that Thailand and Malaysia still hold great potential to increase cooperation, especially in trade and investment and tourism. The Memorandum of Understanding on Cross-Border Transport of Goods was encouraged, as was joint work between local chambers of commerce. For tourism development, Thailand indicated its readiness to facilitate the many tourists that regularly cross over into the southern region, including temporarily exempting Malaysian tourists from filling out immigration clearance forms at Sabah checkpoints. It was also agreed that both sides should push ahead with projects connecting Sadao checkpoint with the Bukit Kayu Hitam checkpoint and the Ratiwa Sumatra to Kelantan Rantau Panjang. Importantly, it was stated that the Rain Stop Service CIQ would be established at Sadao checkpoint to aid in achieving a goal of increasing bilateral trade to 1 billion baht by 2025. The checkpoint was responsible for 7.69 billion baht in revenue in 2023, serving close to 6 million people. Touching on other issues, the two countries resolved to combat cross-border wildlife smuggling, while at the same time promoting agriculture, especially to produce halal food. Most crucially, sustained support was voiced by Malaysia or Thailand's Peace Dialogue Panel, which comprises members from the National Security Council, Central Border Provinces Administration Center, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Ministry of Justice, and the Internal Security Operation Command, Region 4. Obstructing the dishonesty and misconduct that leads to corruption in its earliest stages, Thailand's government is working to instill values of honesty and responsibility into the nation's children. Children are being taught to maintain their integrity daily, to never cheat or lie, and to respect the rule of law. These efforts are fostering a new generation that is free of corruption.
For the advancement of ASEAN as a community, Thailand is not only supporting and promoting digital cooperation, introducing and adopting innovations that improve digital connections in the region, but giving attention to the sustainability of these developments. Encouraging a care economy as much as online communication, Thailand is aiding ASEAN to not only prosper, but thrive into the future. My Thai Diary, write and explore every story of Thailand with us. Many English-speaking foreigners who moved to Thailand struggled to learn the Thai language. Things like the five tones and the writing structure can seem impossible to absorb. Dozens of blog entries profess to hold the key to learning what many foreigners consider a difficult language. While some insist on learning to read before anything else, others recommend speaking Thai first. Institutions such as Duke Language School in Bangkok have reported benefits from both approaches. According to Duke, the benefits of learning to speak Thai first include faster communication and understanding. On the other hand, the benefits of learning to read first include accessibility to written sources, understanding proper Thai sounds, learning independently and at one's own pace, and earning a considerable degree of respect from locals. ¶¶ The question of whether non-Thai speakers should learn Thai through speaking or reading first has been the subject of numerous conversations among learners of the language. Jessica Wei Banyonglat, an assistant professor at the Faculty of Economics at Chulalongkorn University, says she learned to speak and read Thai fluently by listening, practicing, and pushing herself to live daily life among Thai communities that don't speak English. Though she still does not write Thai, she speaks and reads the language fluently, noting that she was self-taught because she did not find the language classes she took particularly helpful. She also teaches English to her students, during which she often speaks Thai when meeting with them privately. Students also say they enjoy practicing speaking English with her.
Sure, Thailand is always equipped with the cutting edge in digital tools. Importance has been given to ensuring widespread coverage of 5G in Thailand by its government, so everyone can access the benefits of the digital realm faster, more effectively, and with greater stability. The government supports necessary infrastructure for 5G. Thailand, for the digital and sustainable society. With sunny beaches for summer and misty mountains for winter, Thailand has no low season and is a prime travel destination year-round, offering cultural as well as creative travels alongside natural attractions. There's always more to see and do in Thailand. Strengthened by government support, visitors can endlessly explore unique Thai identities and sites no matter the season.